The purpose of the workshop is to bring together people from all over Latin America, representing many, many different sectors, who all have an interest in the future of productive and safe and healthy and nutritious agriculture and food systems. In the World Bank, we've noticed for some time that, particularly in the Latin American and Caribbean region, agriculture seems to be getting less attention from policymakers compared to other regions of the world, for example, Africa or Asia. And one of the reasons is that many countries in Latin America are more developed, they're more urbanized, we have more people living in cities. And so the importance of the rural sector and the agricultural sector in the minds of many politicians has diminished a bit. But we feel that it's very important to think not only in terms of primary agriculture, growing crops and raising animals, but also in the larger food system, and thinking about what not only what we're producing, but what we're consuming to make sure that it's healthy and that it's nutritious. We're thinking also about the employment and the jobs that the agriculture and food system can create. And we're thinking about the whole relationship between agriculture and the environment, because we know that agriculture is an enormous user of natural resources. The purpose of this workshop is to bring together people and do some scenarios modeling work. One of the things that analytically we're quite good at is doing sort of quantitative modeling, where we build a model and we project out the future scenarios and using trends of existing information and existing patterns of behavior that we observe: urbanization, population growth, income growth. What we're not always so good at is anticipating unexpected things that could come. And so that's where scenarios modeling can really help this exercise that we're working on, bringing together people to maybe imagine worlds that we normally don't think about, where unexpected events could come along to change the trajectory of the food system. And then doing those scenarios, we'll try to identify what might be threats to the system, what might be opportunities that we can seize, and what should the different actors be doing now? What actions should they be taking to prepare for some of these future worlds that are very uncertain? Well, we've gone through an exercise already, including doing a large-scale survey with many actors in the system to try to identify and then prioritize what would be the main threats to the system, or let's say first the main drivers that are shaping, that have a likelihood of shaping the future trajectory of the system. So they fall into different categories. Some of them are demographic trends, so they're the longer-term trends that I talked about in the future, but they're also short-term events that could come along. Some countries that we've seen in recent years are very fragile, where we can have political disruptions leading to overnight large-scale migration, for example. So there are a set of possible drivers like that, which are uncertain, which could change the system. Another big one, of course, is climate change. So climate change, we know there's still some differences between what the different models predict. But we know we can anticipate that there are going to be sort of long-run changes in temperature and in precipitation levels, which are longer-run effects. But we also know that climate change is going to result in more extreme weather patterns and more natural disasters, which are going to have a huge impact on the agriculture and food system. So that would be another one of these forces that is a potential threat to the system. In terms of opportunities, technologies. We know there are a lot of technologies coming along that are really changing the way food is grown, food is processed, food is transported, food is consumed. Everything from big data and blockchain and artificial intelligence at a very high level, which allows more intelligent design of insurance products, more accessible financial systems for small farmers, which are all being driven by this data revolution. And then at the field level, we're seeing at the actual production level, we're seeing robotics coming in, we're seeing precision agriculture, we're seeing new genomic technologies that are really changing crops and animals, their productivity and their nutritional content. So those offer us some very big opportunities. And then in the background to everything, of course, there are policies. We know that the the world of agriculture and food can change very dramatically depending on what policies are in place. And so there's some basic things, macro and fiscal policies, currency exchange rate policies, which in the background always affect agriculture. But in the short term, we can see things like trade wars breaking out, as we've seen in the last year, you know, which can have huge impacts on the incentives to produce, export, and import agricultural and food products. So those, the policies can actually be both a threat and they can be an opportunity. If they're done well, they're an opportunity to make the system evolve in ways that we would like to see it evolve. If policies are done badly, we can see the agriculture and food system really going in directions that we don't want to see.